It's amazing that we live above the clouds.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip.
Well, the question would be, why a cornice brake on an off-grid homestead? Here you can see the cornice brake that we traveled in one of our previous episodes to go get. In this picture you can see some copper and steel awnings that we fabricated. You actually could stand elephants on these awnings. They're steel and copper. We had to high definition plasma cut the vertical horizontal pieces, the supports for these awnings, and then we fabricated the sub base out of steel and welded it together and then skinned it with copper and standing seam, and then we patinaed and installed these. We installed these lower awnings and the upper awnings on this commercial building. Here we got a copper backsplash that we patinaed to complement the granite countertops. Here's a copper barbecue bar on a deck. This is all copper bent on the cornice brake and then patinaed to age it. Here we have the entrance to a commercial establishment, and the floors are all stained and polished concrete. The front of this entrance counter is copper. You can see in these pictures there's some vertical pieces on here and around the top. This was all copper that was bent on a cornice brake. We then patinaed it or aged it and then installed it in this commercial establishment. Here we have a copper shroud and cap at the top of a chimney. You can see the radius on the shroud that was built on a cornice brake. It was bent and then radius on a cornice brake. And then you can see the steps going down to the brick that was all bent on a cornice brake. We aged it and then installed it in this home. Here we have another chimney top or shroud. This is all steel and copper. Copper standing seam around the base there, that's copper. And just above that is what they call expanded metal to allow the smoke to pass through. Here's another copper shrouding cap. This goes on top of the chimney. Again, built and formed on a cornice brake. Here we have a copper range hood. This is a copper range hood and it's patinaed. The interior, it's all stainless steel. That's an exhaust hood for a cooktop. Here we have an eyebrow roof. That's copper. All the flashing was formed on a cornice brake and all the roof panels were formed on a cornice brake. To the right, you have a dormer window with the cornice or trim molding around the base is copper, and then it's a standing seam radiused roof and copper flashing. This is in a kitchen. We have a cooktop and a stainless steel countertop with radius edges all bent and formed on a cornice brake and then installed in this home. Stainless steel, 16 gauge stainless steel. There, this is a younger me. I was about 30 here. Installed a railing for a customer's home, and that's a meadow in the back. Here we had a customer that had a piece of granite and then they wanted a dining room table fabricated out of steel and copper. The edge is all copper, formed on a cornice brake, the radiuses and the bends, and then patinaed and installed in a customer's home. Front door entry, copper and steel, fireplace screen, copper and stainless fireplace screen. Here we have a gazebo that we fabricated. It's all steel subbase with a copper roof and a copper ball. We fabricated this and then disassembled it and then reassembled it on the customer's property. We even made the ball at the top. If you could picture like an orange, the slices of an orange, that's how the ball was fabricated and then welded together and polished, and then it was all patinaed to look like it had been there. This is a copper mantle. This was a for a customer that had a shipyard, and we fabricated this mantle out of copper, welded it together, polished it. It was pretty neat. This house was in the middle of nowhere, and he had the first Shelby ever built, the first Shelby ever built, in his living room. Here's a copper range hood. The interior is all stainless steel. We fabricated this in a shop. We bent all these pieces on a Cornice Brake. The ribs were bent channels, and then I took poly and I cut it on a table saw, and I inserted poly into these ribs, and then I rolled them to give the radius in order to keep the edges from being crushed. The corners are all made out of 8 separate pieces and then welded together. And at the ceiling, you have cornice molding or trim molding at the top. This was all formed on a Cornice Brake. Here's another example of the same type of hood, a little different design, but it's copper and patinaed. Here's another one, copper and patinaed. And at the ceiling, you can see that cornice or trim molding around the top. On old buildings, if you go into a city and you look at the tops of buildings, a lot of the old buildings, that decorative trim work around the top of a building, a lot of that is metal, sheet metal, and formed on a Cornice Brake. This is a hood, range hood, and it's stainless steel on the inside, copper on the exterior. You get this shiny copper, and then the birds and the trees, that's all copper. And then the sides of the range hood going up the sides, that's all copper. It's all aged. The scenes on the side of this range hood depict the different sides of this house and what was happening at the time that we walked around the house. Here you can see the range hood at a distance. You can also see the ventilation pipe coming out the back. You can see that this range hood wraps around this timber construction. And then out the back, we had to run the ventilation out the back and up through the roof. All this piping is made out of copper, lined with stainless steel. We fabricated all that pipe. There's another view of this hood. And the lights, little puck lights on the inside. And you can see how that pipe comes out the back and goes up through the ceiling. This is a railing in somebody's home that we fabricated. It's all wrought iron, hammered, distressed steel with a copper railing. And then on top of the posts, the wood posts, those were copper caps in somebody's home. Another stainless steel and copper range hood. Again, another stainless steel and copper range hood. This one is convex versus the other ones, which were concave. You still have the ribs on the outside. Those are copper. This was all formed on a Cornice Brake. All these ribs and everything. And we used poly sheeting cut on a table saw to install into these, well, we fabricated these like U channels. And then we put the poly sheeting in the copper and then we rolled them to get this shape. This is a steel and stainless steel range hood. The black is steel, and then you have the stainless steel and the stainless steel interior, the stainless steel and copper range hood, stainless steel range hood, another stainless steel range hood. Here we have some copper planter boxes above somebody's garage. This was all copper formed on a Cornice Brake with steel ribs. So the steel formed a skeleton, but it's like an exoskeleton. It's on the outside. And then on the interior, the steel is lined with copper. And then the copper's all aged, look distressed. There's another view of those planters. You can see the steel on the outside and then the copper, aged copper. This is like a dinette table, little table with a copper top, distressed copper top hammered. It's patinaed and aged, and then it's bent and formed and welded on all the corners on top of this table. Here we can see the top of a spiral staircase. On the top of the staircase, you can see there's some expanded metal treads on the top. Next to it, you can see that there's a stainless steel railing, a stainless steel cable railing. So all these treads or steps as you're coming down this staircase were all formed on a Cornice Brake. This was fabricated at somebody's home. You can see as the treads come down, it spirals down and wraps around this center pole. But the diamond plate treads would offer a little bit of grip. This is another view of the entrance to a building. This is a copper front, which mirrors and matches the stained concrete floor. This was bent on a Cornice Brake and then installed in place. And this was a little bit of fun. Yeah, up to the left, you get a copper lampshade on a lamp. And then to the right of that, you got some copper lampshades. And then to the left in the middle, you got a copper base, which is formed and bent on a Cornice Brake and then welded together with a copper shade. To the right of that is another lamp. Well, it's a fairly large lamp, but this one, the base is a maple burl, and then the upright is a distressed copper riser. It's shiny copper. Then you have the shade, which is a shiny copper and patinaed copper. And then below that, standing erect there, you have a brass and copper rose. Head of the rose was patinaed a pinkish red color. And then to the left on the bottom there, you have another lampshade. So we're going to use this Cornice Brake to fabricate some of the flashing on our timber frame home, some of the flashing on our property, some gutters, and some of the interior details in our home. That's what we're going to be using the Cornice Brake for. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and you've watched some of our previous videos, make sure you like and you subscribe. You don't want to miss as we fabricate using our Cornice Brake.